Hi, I'm Suzanne Smiley with Atlas RFID Store, and we are here today at RFID Journal Live 2013. I'm here with Scot Stelter from Impinj.
Hi, I'm Scot Stelter. I'm with Impinj, Senior Director of Product Marketing for Impinj. I'll give you a little tour of the booth. I'm going to start with our xArray demo. The xArray is actually a phased array reader that's mounted in the ceiling of a retail store and can monitor tagged inventory in the store constantly 24/7. And what this demo is doing, I'll show you the phased array, the xArray reader in a moment, but I'll tell you that it's mounted about 12 feet above the center of our booth. And what this demo is doing is it's tracking the location of employees in the booth. Employees have a tag on their lanyard and it knows where they are and it can track their activities. So this sort of product is applicable in retail inventory situations, asset tracking, logistics. Anytime you want to know not only whether the tag is in the field, but also you want some pretty good RTLS capability. You don't need really super high location precision, inches or feet, but you want to know roughly where something is. This is a very good way to do it. And if we walk up here, I'll show you the actual device. So the xArray is hanging from the ceiling there. It's hanging at about 12 feet. In a retail store situation, you might hang it at 15 feet. And at 15 feet, it can monitor a circle that has a diameter of 40 feet. And we've done testing in retail stores, and what we've discovered is that the success rate in terms of capturing all the tags exceeds that of handhelds by several percentage points. So it's very, very effective for inventory applications in a retail environment, as well as I said, asset tracking and RTLS applications.
That's impressive. I guess we were a little bit out of range for it over there, but that's really cool that y'all can do that in the retail environment. Is there any other environment that's really good for this?
Well, as I was saying, asset tracking, so a great example would be healthcare. Hospitals very often have a lot of extra money invested in capital equipment because they can't find their equipment. In fact, in some cases, they actually abandon equipment because it gets lost and they can't find it. As you know, hospital equipment is very expensive. 10,000, 100,000, maybe more. And so losing that equipment is very, very costly. The alternatives are active tagging systems, like the new Wi-Fi RTLS systems. The problem with those is that the tags are battery powered. They usually cost tens of dollars. With the xArray, you can actually use UHF Gen 2 passive tags, which cost pennies, maybe a dollar if they're encased in plastic. So it's very, very cost effective if you have a lot of things to tag. And it's a very good substitute for very expensive active tagging solutions for asset tracking.
Okay, great. Well, is there anything more we should know about the xArray before we move on?
Right now with the xArray, we're doing an early access program with selected partners. And we're doing evaluations and pilot projects. We've already got the xArray running in two retail stores. And then in 2014, we'll be rolling out as a production product.
Oh, fabulous. All right, great. Well, what else do you have out here?
Well, the other product that we have that's a Best in Show nominee is our RS500, which is a system-in-package solution for embedding RFID into devices. It's basically a reader, complete reader, based on an Impinj Indie reader chip, and I'll show you that over here.
Okay, great.
It's a complete reader, and I'm pointing at the box here, not this package. This package is just to demonstrate it. But what we've done in this demo here is we've taken the chip on this board. All you need to do is attach power. In this case, it's via a USB cable. And an antenna, and now you can read tags. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put a longer range antenna.
Yeah. Okay. So is that your Matchbox antenna?
No, this is a different antenna. This is the Matchbox antenna right here.
Right. Yeah, I recognize
for
that.
For obvious reasons why it's called a Matchbox antenna. It's also a fairly short range antenna. This is a somewhat longer range antenna. I'm going to attach it here. And all I'm doing is attaching antennas here. There's no special magic. And again, I can learn about the RS500, I can read that tag. Here's another short range tag. And this shows actually how it's assembled. So there's the RS500. All you do is add an antenna, DC power, and a UART. So it really is the easiest way to embed RFID inside of something. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a long-range tag, and I'm just going to show you how long the range is.
Oh, wow.
Now, this is not meant to be a long-range product. but we can get a good 2 meters out of it, and it's still going strong. Okay, so I got about 2 meters out of it. It operates at 23 dBm, which is lower power than the maximum FCC allows, but it's just the right power level for embedding RFID inside of things. For example, there's a application where a soda fountain dispenser actually has all of the flavor cartridges tagged, and there are reader chips inside that soda fountain dispenser, and they keep track of the cartridges. This would be a great way to do that inside of another device. I've heard of people doing tracking oil filters inside of engines, people tracking in retail kiosks, vendor-managed inventory, like in auto parts stores, that sort of thing. So it's really the perfect app, perfect way, very easy way to embed RFID inside of a non-RFID thing.
Great. Well, is this product currently on the market, or is this going to come out soon?
The product was announced last week. We're sampling in June, and it'll be in production in October. So we're going to already engaging with OEMs who are developing products based on this product.
Fabulous, and it's great that it's customizable with different read ranges for different antennas. So you can do, depending on your application, you can use the antenna that you need and you can get that read range that you're looking for.
That's exactly right. So you use the choice of your antenna determines the application that you're implementing.
Sure. Were y'all having a good time at RFID Journal Live?
Certainly are. Yeah, it's a great show. A lot of people here.
Yeah, as you can tell, this booth is crazy busy. So, I mean, Impinj products are awesome. We love selling them. So I'm so glad we got to sit here and get the product demonstration. Is there anything else you want to tell us about Impinj and what y'all are doing upcoming?
Yeah, there's one other thing I'd like to tell you about. We announced our source tagging platform 2.0 this week. Source tagging platform 2.0, or STP 2.0, is a big performance and functionality boost over our STP 1.0. The source tagging platform is a platform for implementing highly reliable, high-speed encoding systems. And this is needed because RFID is not going to scale unless people who need to tag many, many things, such as in apparel, can tag them at very high reliability, very, very fast. In other words, inexpensively. So we're looking to minimize the total applied tag cost by making encoding very reliable and very high speed. And there are three locations here in the show where people are using our source tagging platform to do high-speed encoding. One of them is a Kirk Rudy over here, and I recommend that you go and visit them. Another is Mid-South Marketing, and a third one will come to me in a moment.
We definitely saw Kirk Rudy yesterday, and we saw how fast they were encoding those tags. That's awesome. And we saw it was powered by Impinj, and so we went over there and talked to them a little bit. It looks like a really cool machine and how they're using it.
That's right. 80,000 tags per minute. Very, very fast. Very, very fast.
That's awesome. All right. Well, I think that about does it for today. But thank you so much, Scot, for talking with us, and we appreciate it. And again, we love installing Impinj products, and thank you for your time.
Likewise. Thank you very much.